Good morning!
Checkup, yeah.
If you not my dog,
I'ma have to cut you off. I'ma have to cut you off. up, I'ma have to cut you off. If you not my dog, I'ma have to cut you off.
And I will cut you off. Good morning, Leela. And I do mean that. If you are not my dog, listen, Tokyo is a handsome dog. If you're not Tokyo, I will have to cut you off. Keep it clean. Thank you, Heaven. I appreciate that. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have had quite a weekend, I should say. Good morning, April. And you know, I always look forward to the weekend because I know that is when the folks on the right, that's their chance to get away with all the lies and misinformation that they can before I catch up to them. And so, you know, I get to go into these lives and listen to all of the issues. Hello, Maisha, I'm doing all right. And I get to listen to all of their grievances, okay? And I just take my notes. Yes, I hear all the complaints. And I just take my notes and I go and I meditated out on them out here in Olympus so that I could come back stronger than ever on Monday. And today is Monday. And so we got a list of things that we are going to be addressing. So, you know the drill. This is time for housekeeping. And I'm sorry for all of you who always hear me say it, but I gotta say it because I know there's new people here that don't know this stuff. So, for those of you who are wondering who I am, yes, I am, as they say, I am Zeus, God of Sky and Thunder. Yes, Biden is making America great. Good point. I am also known as Triple H. Why do they call you Triple H? Why do they call you that? Well, they call me Triple H, ladies and gentlemen, because I am honest. I am the most honest person on this platform, on all platforms. I am, especially YouTube. Even though there's a lot of Trump supporters on YouTube that hate me, I don't care. I'm still going to be honest. Humble. I am the most humble person on social media. Listen, if I step on your toes, I'll go, oops, I am so sorry. I didn't mean to step on your toes. I have no problem apologizing if I am wrong. Thank you for those gifts and follows, by the way. So I'm the honest, most honest, and I am the most humble person that you've ever ran into. Hands down, second to none. And the last H, ladies and gentlemen, is because I am the most handsome. Do they know? Now, for the Trump supporters that are here and the people on the right, this live, we do hold you accountable for all forms of lies and misinformation. That's what we do over here on this side. And it's for your own benefit. All right. So if you are a Trump supporter, now is your time to retreat. Yeah, retreat. Yeah. You don't have to stay here if you don't want to.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave.
That's
right.
As far
as I'm concerned, if you hate our country.
Good morning, attacking.
If you're not happy here, you can leave.
That's right.
If you're not happy in the U.S.
That's right.
If you're complaining all the time.
Listen to your leader.
Simply, you can leave. You can leave right now.
That's
come
right.
Back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay, too.
That's right.
But if you're not happy, you can leave.
That's right. So anybody that's here after this warning, I'm just going to assume you are here because you choose to be here and you want to be set free, especially if you're a Trump supporter. Because you know, like we know, you've been sold a bad bill of goods by the Republican Party and Donald J. Trump. And with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, order in the court. Now let's get into this before I open up these boxes, because many of you know I don't have a problem talking to anyone as long as they're respectful. So Obama and Steve Colbert, they are among 500 Americans that have been banned from Russia. And this is, as you can say, one of the most fascinating things, because you know who wasn't banned? You know who wasn't banned? Donald J. Trump. Listen, I have said and I've always maintained that the former president, Donald J. Trump, he has the earmarkings of a Russian operative. And anybody. Oh, Trump? What did you say? Trump has not lied about Russia. Okay. That is considered lies and misinformation. Oh, the poll results are in. And listen, being honest is the West is the best H in Triple H. So, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you. I am the most honest. Now, the question is, why won't Putin, thank you for the gifts, why won't Putin ban Donald J. Trump? Does anybody know? See, that's the question that keeps me up late at night. And for any of you who continue to support Trump, I would love to know what you think is the reason that Putin won't ban Donald J. Trump. See, Donald Trump has this lie circulating out here. He tries to portray himself as tough on Russia. He tries to portray himself as tough on China. And he tries to portray himself as tough on North Korea. But when you find that these guys are writing Donald J. Trump love letters and they refuse to ban him, but they want to ban America's greatest president, one of America's greatest president, Barack Hussein Obama, this lets it be known that obviously Donald J. Trump, as far as I'm concerned in this kingdom, is a Russian asset. I know, they don't like it when I say it, but I'm telling you the truth. Would you rather me lie like these so-called fake TikTok hosts do? You should see these fake TikTok hosts, ladies and gentlemen. You should see it. They are, because of the accountability that I've been bringing on this platform, they are doing some of the most ridiculous styles and types of content I have ever seen. They always seem to be arguing about these random off-the-focus topics. Like right now, they like to talk about transgender. Well, I have some news about that. And when we talk about it later on in the show today, I want all of my Republican friends that are angry with transgender, I want them to explain it, okay? Because I got something to bring up. You know I'm going to come with something, right? Okay? For instance, okay? Now, you know how these folks on the right, they love to say they stand up for the veterans. They're not trying to cut the VA benefits, even with that 22% budget cut that Kevin McCarthy is trying to bring. Okay, even with that, you will still have Republicans out here saying, we don't want to cut the benefits to the veterans. Read the bill, Zeus, is what they tell me. Read the bill. Find out. On what line does it say directly cutting benefits to the veterans? They say this kind of stuff. And to those who like to do that, I'm going to say this. Shame on you if you don't understand how budgets work. See, a lot of people get it confused. If you come out and you tell somebody there's going to be a 22% hit to your bottom line, you just imagine this. I come to your house and I say, you know what? I'm going to take 22% out of your budget. And I tell you, guess what? But that's not going to involve me taking any food off your table. Would you believe me? Would you believe me if I really told you that? So if you wouldn't believe me, why would you believe the Republican Party, who we continue to find has lied about every single thing that is of critical importance, i.e. who won the 2020 election? The Republican Party has failed to tell the truth about that. Who was responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th, i.e. the Republican Party has failed to tell you the truth about that. So I'm not arguing with you if you come in here and you tell me, well, Zeus, that 22% won't be a cut to the veterans, I'm going to tell you, you know what? I appreciate that's your opinion, but the evidence suggests otherwise. The Republican Party continues to be a party that gets people to vote in their own worst interest. You got them now debating immigration, for instance. Look at the state of Florida. Chaos and pandemonium. But you will still have these folks on the right trying to tell you Ron DeSantis is doing the right thing. To the folks out there who continue to believe this stuff, cut it out. Now, I bring that all up because the mayor of New York, Eric Adams, yes, he had to go on national television. What a shame. And call for an investigation into the false story of homeless veterans being displaced by immigrants. I wish, I know. And I wish, and Fox News, they actually played this story for millions of viewers to talk about. And then you go into these lives on TikTok, and what are these fake TikTok hosts talking about? Oh, migrants are displacing veterans in New York, a Democrat city. And they do this whole thing on TikTok only to find out under the cover of night that Fox News had to retract the story. And we find out this whole story was fake. And now they want an investigation into who did it. I'm going to tell you who did it. The Republicans. I wish Eric Adams, listen up, come reach out to Zeus. Eric Adams, whatever budget you are trying to allocate to investigate this thing, you come over and talk to Zeus. I will find the very TikTok host, the very news network, and the very individuals who are responsible for circulating these form of lies and misinformation. And I'm pretty sure if we look deep enough, we will end up on a QAnon website of sorts. That's why I say don't trust any of these folks, especially those in the Republican Party, until they admit some of the most fundamental basic things are true, i.e. who was responsible for the attack on the Capitol and who won the 2020 election. Speaking of the Republican Party, I got to bring it up. You know I don't mind doing it. Now, here we go, and I'm going to be brief on this. And then, you know, like I said, I still got some time before I open up these boxes. Jim Jordan, ladies and gentlemen, as if he didn't do enough damage last week with his crazy FBI whistleblower complaint fiasco, as if he didn't do enough damage with that. The nation is still reeling, by the way, in the wake of that whole thing, because the part that still gives me nightmares is the Cash Patel part. All of you are getting paid by Donald Trump to come in here and lie to the American people? Wow. And one guy actually said he doesn't know. What's his last name? Boyle. Did you get any money from Cash Patel? Not that I know of. But then it comes out that he was getting funding from a nonprofit that Cash Patel is actually paying for. Don't be mad at me. Don't be mad at me. I'm just shocked that there are still people out here who believe these folks. I'm really shocked. So now, and Jim Jordan, in the wake of all of this, is threatening to cut funding after this whole fiasco. Ladies and gentlemen, are there really Republicans out here? Are there really Trump supporters out here who really believe that Jim Jordan and the Republicans should be cutting the FBI funding? Are there any Trump supporters out here that think that the FBI should have his funding cut? Are you there, or is this just Jim Jordan talking? Are there any Trump supporters out there that think the FBI should be cutting, Jim Jordan? Wow, Steve, really? So Steve, I hate to do it to you, Steve. Are you in favor of defunding the police? Is that what you're basically conceding to? Okay? Because if you say yes, you already said yes. So why was it a problem? Okay, so the FBI is corrupt? Is that what I'm hearing? You want to defund them because the FBI is corrupt. When the Democrats, you said, were saying defund the police, why was it a problem? Hank, why was it a problem when the Democrats were saying it? Okay, because I'm confused. I'm just asking a question. Did they just become corrupt? Am I missing something? Am I missing something?
Help me!
Make it make sense. FBI is not part of the... Oh. The FBI is not part of the blue. Wow. Well, wow. Okay. I got to dive into that. At another point in time. Because I just wanted to know, from your perspective, when did you realize that the FBI was corrupt? And if you believe that the FBI is corrupt, wouldn't that make these whistleblowers also corrupt as well? Think about it. You can't keep trying to take out bits and pieces of the FBI that you like and then say, now this part, this is great because it supports what we believe, but this other part, oh, it's corrupt. It's part of the Hunter Biden, Joe Biden, Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton, deep state. Cut it out. Now, there's something of grave importance, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of my friends on the right that I do want to bring up, let me bring this up full to your attention. Let me bring this up. Because, like I said earlier, there's been a lot of talks about transgender issues, right? Boy, oh boy, oh boy. So, Marjorie Taylor Greene, we gotcha. Gotcha, Marjorie Taylor Greene. We really do. Another example of Republicans getting caught with their hands in the cookie jar. So Marjorie Taylor Greene, who has been raging for months about drag queens, is now having to defend her boyfriend over an old video of him donning drag in Dallas. Let's see if I can cue it up. Let's see. I know you can't see it, but her boyfriend is dressed in drag.
Okay. And I am off course. I can tell you, I don't think a lot, I think a lot of people up now. They're all hashtag I am off course. Come and check it out here. Starts on Saturday. I'm kicking these shoes off. But I may keep the pantyhose on. This feels kind of good. Actually, I'm not going to pee in them, I promise. I'll send it back to the studio. I can tell you, I think a lot of people up now. They're all hashtag I am off. Of course, come and check it out here. Starts on Saturday. I'm kicking these shoes off. But I may keep the pantyhose on. This feels kind of good. Actually, I'm not going to pee in them, I promise. I'll send it back to the studio.
Her boyfriend says, I may keep these shoes on. I may keep these shoes on and the pantyhose, but I'm not going to urinate in them. Who am I to judge? My thing is, I'm not judging this, but I am judging Marjorie Taylor Greene and all of the Republicans. So, you know where my mind goes from here on out. From here on out, anybody that's on the right that I see holding lives about transgender issues, I am just going to assume that in your past, somewhere, you were involved with these kind of activities, and I am going to take what you say very lightly, okay? Because the outrage that I'm seeing makes absolutely no sense. Every single time I hear or see some of these folks on the right trying to so-called call out these Democrats, for instance, or people for doing things we end up seeing them doing the exact same thing. We've seen Rudy Giuliani in a dress, and we've seen the former president, Donald Trump, motorboating Rudy Giuliani while he was in the dress in his bosom. Every single issue the Republicans try to say they are standing for, we find out if you just go and look at their social media pages, you go look at their history, they're not as they say they are. We care about the kids. This is what they say. We're trying to protect the kids. We don't want things to happen to them. But you listen to what they say. You go look at who's getting arrested and indicted. It's them. Shame. 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 And you know what Marjorie Taylor Greene had to say about all of this? Should we look at her tweet? Look at her tweet. She blames it once again on the Democrats. Can you believe it? Wow, Marjorie Taylor Greene. The left is so stupid. Well, you know what, Marjorie Taylor Greene? I'm going to have to push back on that. And I'm going to say, if you believe that we are stupid, then sign me up for it. Because what I am not going to do is let you pee on my leg and tell me it's raining outside. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is hypocrisy right on display for all to see. And because of what she has done, the things that she has said in this kingdom, Marjorie Taylor Greene has been found guilty of blasphemy and treason. Put her in the court. Get her out of here. Get her out of here. And any of you who do any more of these lives about transgender issues, and I hear your rhetoric, you too will be found guilty of treason and blasphemy. As far as I'm concerned, you need to let it go and clean up your own act. Hypocrites. Look at them. Where are they at? I don't think there's any Trump supporter in this live that can actually defend this successfully. If you believe I got this wrong, feel free. We can talk about it. I'm just saying, don't call nobody else out about anything they do in the comfort of their own home or when they out and about living their life. Leave them alone. Like I said, tell the government to get out of your business, because guess what? That's what you're supposed to be standing for. Now let's move it on, ladies and gentlemen, before I open up these boxes. Like I said, they don't like me because I tell the truth. But guess what? I'd rather tell the truth and be realer than you than to be out here believing a lie. Now, the last topic that I want to bring front and center is more trouble in Trump world. Yes.
Help me!
Oh, yes. Trump's attorneys have kept incriminating notes about those classified documents. And guess who has them? Jack Smith has them, ladies and gentlemen.
Jack Smith is a Trump hater. His wife's a Trump hater. His family is a Trump hater. They all hate Trump. They hate him with a passion. They'll do anything they can to hurt Trump. But he's a harasser and an abuser.
Oh, yes!
Jack Smith is a Trump hater. His wife's a Trump hater. His family is a Trump hater. They all hate Trump. They hate him with a passion. They'll do anything they can to hurt Trump. He's a harasser and abuser.
Get him!
Jack Smith.
Get him, Jack!
He's a Trump hater. He likes a Trump hater. His family is a Trump hater. They all hate Trump. They have been a passion. They'll do anything they can. He's a harasser and an abuser.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you for those gifts, by the way. This is how you know Jack Smith is worth every dollar he's earning. You should see that right now we have Trump's own attorneys arguing with each other. You know, this is like a married couple arguing in the car right now. His attorneys, they're telling on each other. They're telling on Donald Trump. Mike Pence has testified. And now, at the top of all of that, what else could Jack Smith deliver to the American people? Trump's own attorney has the incriminating evidence. Unprecedented, folks. Unprecedented. His lawyer told that, according to the research, his own attorney told Trump that he could not hold on to those classified documents after he was ordered to hand them over. And the federal government has proof that his own attorney. So you know the attorneys, they knew that Trump was up to no good. They found 40 classified documents at one point in Mar-a-Lago, but told the Justice Department that there was nothing else. They did, which later turned out to be false because in August, as you all know, the FBI showed up and seized over 100 documents. And you know, if I were an attorney of Donald Trump, actually most attorneys know it's a bad idea to actually believe 100% that your client is innocent. You better do everything in your power that you've been trained to do to make sure that, one, you're doing your best to actually provide a good defense to your client. I get that. But the next thing is you have to also make sure you're not committing anything that's going to further the crime. And Trump's attorneys knew what they were doing, and they had to make sure they did this when they were dealing with this guy, because Trump is the ultimate criminal. He is. Okay, now this attorney had taken contemporaneous notes, which prosecutors showed to a grand jury after an appeals court allowed attorney-client privilege to be pierced because they found that Trump might have used his attorney's advice to commit further crimes. Yeah, this is, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not making this stuff up. You can go look this up. Prosecutors have zeroed in on Trump's valet, Walt Nuta. Okay, who told investigators that former president told him to remove the boxes. I don't want to hear about President Biden's boxes. You hear Trump on Biden had 1,800 boxes. This is what Trump says. Hunter Biden has some boxes. Who else? Mike Pence, Obama had boxes. This is what Trump's talking about. I don't want to hear it, Trump. We got the receipts on you. Okay. So he tells his valet to move the boxes from the storage room before and after the subpoena was issued, okay, for the documents returned. And they got surveillance video showing him doing just that. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to let you know it's over for Donald J. Trump. You know what? For Donald J. Trump, this is what I'm going to say. It's over, sir. Trump, this right here, as far as I am concerned, is one of the last shoes to drop. I really don't know what other forms of evidence that can exist to incriminate you. The worst kind of evidence is obviously being on camera, caught doing something. And you mean to tell me that Jack Smith not only has you on camera, but he actually has sworn testimony and contemporaneous notes, meticulous notes? Excuse me, I'm getting choked up over here. I'm just thinking, what person out here that still supports Donald Trump believes he's innocent? You really can't believe he's innocent at this point. That, as far as I am concerned, is what you have to really come to grips with. The jury will be deliberating. And when you're deliberating, there's not going to be Trump in there. There's not going to be the prosecutor. This is just going to be a bucket full of evidence. And you have to look at that and go, is this evidence enough to demonstrate that this individual is responsible. And there's not a court on this planet that will see that evidence in the effort to uphold justice, say that's not enough to convict him. As far as I am concerned, Trump's goose is cooked. Abort mission, because it's not going to end nicely, ladies and gentlemen. So for those of you who continue to support Donald J. Trump, I'm just here to help you understand. The playtime is over. That Jack Smith is something else, I tell you. I've always said, here's a little trick to do to the Trump supporters. There's a new trick going around. I haven't done this in a while. But I hear that if you're going to the bathroom and you turn down those lights, right, you just get them real nice and dim, and you whisper, Jack Smith. And you spin around, and then you go, Jack Smith. And then you spin around again, and you say it. I'm not going to say it, but I heard that if you say it three times, the FBI will show up. Order! All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got to open up these boxes and hear from all of you. Yes, like Candyman, okay? Because, listen, over here, ladies and gentlemen, I don't have to lie to you. I don't have to try to manipulate you into believing what I'm saying. I just simply get out here and I tell the truth, okay? So, do not be mad at me. Do not be mad at any of these viewers, because we've taken time out of our busy lives to make sure that you will not be confused about who to vote for come that time to vote. That's all. No, I'm not a Democrat operative. I am a truth-sayer, ladies and gentlemen. I am as they say I am. I am Triple H, and that is because I truly do care about you. Now, before I open up these boxes, ladies and gentlemen, you know the deal. Just get in here, tell the truth, okay? And you know, no need to yell because you're angry and frustrated. If the content that you heard today makes you feel upset and frustrated, do me a huge favor. Go outside, go for about a 2-mile walk, and just think about what you heard and what's being said before you actually come in and talk to me, okay? Because you're going to find out. You're really not frustrated with me. You're going to find that out. Oh, yes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, our first guest. Brother Alex, good morning. Nice to see you. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good, Zeus. I feel like today I need to provide some good truth about the VA and veterans, because that's where, you know, my heart lies as a veteran myself that currently works in the VA.
Okay. All right. Let's do it.
So, again, what I like to do, I never like to argue facts. We can argue opinions, but we'll never argue facts, right?
Right.
So, first, let's come out and be clear. The story that was, portrayed by the Republican outlets about veterans being kicked out of hotels is 100% false.
Mm-hmm.
The veterans have come up. The veterans supposedly involved in the story has come forth and said it was false. So at that particular point, if you still disagree, now you're calling the veterans a liars that were a part of the story. So let's get that out of the way.
What a shame. Wow.
So let me get some facts. And this is public knowledge. You can go on the VA websites. So during 2022, the VA has housed more than 40,000 veterans in permanent housing. And their goal was to get around 38,000. So it's 6.3 increase from what their goal was for 2022.
Tell them.
Since January of 2020, it has been an 11% decrease in homeless veterans.
Oh, so that means there's real work being done.
There's real work being done.
Veterans.
Yes. And what I like to say, and this is for everybody, is just because you see a veteran on the street, there's always a story to a veteran. I'll give you a quick example. In my VA, I can probably give you 20 to 30 veterans who are unfortunately going through substance abuse issues. We put them in housing and they keep getting kicked out of housing because of unfortunately drugs. So of course, you're gonna keep getting kicked out of your permanent housing. So we put them in rehabs. But again, my biggest point is that there's always a story to a veteran. Just because you see a veteran on the street does not mean that the VA is not helping them.
Mm.
So please do your due diligence. If something sounds kind of far-fetched to believe, like veterans getting kicked out for, you know, migrants, it's typically, I like to say, I like to see the data behind it or the research behind it.
Right. Do your own research.
So again, when it comes to veterans, we can argue opinions all day, but we will never argue the facts.
Someone said put them in rehab, Brother Alex. What do you got to say about that? Are you offering services to help them get treatment?
Yes. Yeah, so the veterans that actually are going through substance abuse are placed in rehab, and they have permanent housing, and typically the rehab programs can last up to 6 months.
Do you hear
that? Free of charge.
You hear that? Someone with direct experience is telling you, cut it out. Stop believing the lies and misinformation.
That's all the truth I wanted to kind of to put forth. And again, this is not me speaking as someone that's opinion. I've worked in the VA for 12 years, so I have intimate firsthand knowledge about what's going on. Now, can the VA do better? We can always do better. But the fact that the VA is not helping the vets, that's just factually untrue.
Thank you for clearing that up. Any questions?
No, sir. That's it.
Listen, I appreciate you, Brother Alex, and thank you for your service as well. You know, it's people like you that I do believe are helping to keep this country on track, okay? Because there's a lot of things happening out here where you could easily throw in the towel and say, you know what? It's not worth doing. But you are maintaining course because you see the good that this country has to offer. You don't like to cozy up to those foreign dictators, do you?
Absolutely not.
You don't sympathize with Russia like some of these folks on the right do you? That's what we're talking about. Real Americans helping Americans. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that shouldn't be so difficult. You got American boots on American soil. It's time you start acting like an American.
And can I make one additional point? So so the issue, the big topic issues, right, is that the CBO, who technically the head of the CEO is a CBO is a Republican, put out a budget proposal about how to, you know, reduce the cuts for the federal government. Mm-hmm. And one of the cuts he recommended was discretionary spending. So we know under discretionary spending, as a VA employee, VA benefits and health care is under that discretionary spending. Did they come out and say we're going to cut the VA budget? Because it's always implied language.
They didn't say that directly, according to some of my research. But you and I know what it is.
Yes, they said they're going to cut discretionary funding. So they asked one of the representatives, Republican representatives, well, are you going to cut the VA fund? He said no, but we should look at how they're spending their money.
Just so like it's you like, say they want to cut FBI funding, right? But they don't want to cut it, right? It's that same kind of talk.
Correct. So but to be honest with you, in my personal opinion, as somebody that works at the VA, will the VA benefits get cut? No. Because what will happen, it'll be a bad PR nightmare, and the veterans on the left and the right will band together at that particular point.
I have faith, and I hope that does work out just as you said, Brother Alex. But in the meantime, what would you suggest, or what would you like to say to those out there who continue to say that the Republicans don't want to cut the veterans' benefits? What would you say to them, especially the voters?
What I would like to say is speak to someone that is informed on how the VA works, and it's even better to speak to someone that works in the VA, because we can kind of tell you what's the conversation going on in the VA when it comes to town halls we're having. Our union representatives are talking to our employees about how the purported cuts might affect the VA. And even then, the director of secretary of the VA, Mr. Robert McDonough, has come out and said that any plan put forth by the Republicans that might cut the benefits of veterans, they're not in support of. So the VA director is coming out against any purported budget cuts for veterans in any fashion or form.
You hear that? You notice he didn't say, go listen to your fake TikTok host. He didn't suggest you do that. He said, go listen to the real people. Okay? Stay out of those nasty lives where all they do is try to scare you. Stay out of there.
you can disagree. I was going to say you can disagree with Democrats all you want to, but Republicans, please don't drag veterans and misinformation into the disagreement. I'm sorry.
Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay, because we're watching you with our eyes, and I got two good eyes, as you can see, and I have eyes and ears all over the place. So, with that being said, thank you, Brother Alex. All forms of lies and misinformation need to cease immediately. Stay out of those lives with those fake TikTok hosts. I'm telling you, they're not helping you, okay? All right, time to bring up the next guest. Oh my gosh, Brother Tekken, yeah.
Good morning,
Brother Tekken.
Good morning. Good morning, Zeus.
Good morning.
You know, you brought up a subject about the kids and the transgenders and stuff like that, and the
You mean Marjorie Taylor Greene?
You know, I you know, being a grandpa, I read a lot of stuff this weekend about kids being taught certain things in school.
Mm-hmm.
And being a good granddad, I realized that maybe when my kids were growing up, I wasn't there. And even though this stuff was being taught last year and a year prior and 10 years prior and 20 years prior, I just don't understand.
Are you okay?
I don't understand how parents can attack it now but not worry about it last year. Why are you Republicans worried about it now but you weren't worried about it last year or 5 years ago? Why all of a sudden are you worried about it today? Is it because it's a talking point to where you can hate the Democrats and blame other people? Are you serious?
Mm.
I mean, my God, it's the same stuff that was taught to kids last year, 2 years ago, 5 years ago. It isn't anything going. Our kids that were taught the books, the same thing.
Tell
our kids are good. My kids are great. You adults who have 14 and 15 year old kids, your kids are great now.
Mm.
But you're worried about all of a sudden you have drag shows, which I'll bet you left at the movies like Mrs. Doubtfire.
Oh, they watched it. I was watching it with them.
Yes. By the way, how was my acting in the beginning?
Oh, it was great. Top of the line. I totally understood. My heart started beating really fast because I was concerned about you. Okay. but to be honest, that's what it sounds like when you go into their live. They're so worked up about this.
Yeah, and you have people like what I just did. You have people. I don't understand why they're doing it now.
Are you okay attacking? You need some tissue because yes,
I studied acting at Lee Strasberg in Los Angeles.
Oh. I appreciate you demonstrating your talent and using it like that because it was needed.
God.
That's exactly what it's like, folks. And you're like, whoa. You mean to tell me, out of all the stuff going on in the world, that's what you're worried about?
Yeah, exactly. Oh, by the way, I need to give you a heads up. I sent you a DM. You know Shannon, who came in here and asked for help? He was changing from Republican to Democrat?
I vaguely remember.
Well, he's a full-on Trump supporter.
Oh.
Because I went to his live like I've done before to try to protect him from Trump lovers. Well, he sided with them. He's got a new Trump-loving page with a whole bunch of posts. So, yeah, he's gone to the dark side.
Oh, well, he's been compromised again. This is what I say. If this is true, this is why I say if you're really trying to get rehabilitated, you can't continue to dibble and dabble in the things that caused you to lapse to begin with.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to drop down. Somebody else up here who has some great information. Thank you for the applause on my performance. You know, I'm here every Thursday, 9 to 5.
Oh, fair enough. All right. Well, listen.
All right.
Thank yeah. you, brother, attacking. All right, bro. So as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, it is not that difficult to get in the box and simply tell the truth. Oh, we have a new guest. Oh, listen. And it's a light day, I guess. I might get out of here on time today. Good morning, we the people.
What's up, Zeus?
What's up? How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm just another day in the kingdom, maintaining order and tending to affairs as usual.
I understand that. Hey, like what Attacking just said, you know, the whole movie with Mrs. Doubtfire, you can't forget about Joanna Man, mm-hmm. White Chicks, Medea. You know, this has been in our media, it's been in our social media, it's been in our movies, been in our TV shows. You can't take it out just yet. I mean, come on now. This stuff's been around for ages. But mm-hmm. what I wanted to touch on was the whole Marjorie Taylor Greene thing.
Oh, let's talk about it.
Okay, well, I'm not a Trump supporter by no means. I don't support, you know, but I am a Republican. If the man did something wrong, lock his butt up, the way I look at it.
I can deal with that. I know a couple of individuals okay. like yourself.
Yeah, I understand. I'm always in your lives, you know, chatting away and, you know, chatting whatever. But did he actually dress up as a drag or was he just trying stuff on?
Oh, no, he dressed up.
Oh, okay. See, I didn't read about that, so I didn't know.
Yeah, he did. He's in full regalia, wig, gloves, dress, pink dress, glasses on, and you heard what I played, right?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. So, what are your thoughts about that? I mean, as far as I'm concerned, you know where I stand. Whatever you want to do that's legal, go for it. That's not my. Yeah. I don't have the right to go inside of your life and tell you how to live it. But my issue was with Marjorie Taylor Greene.
I understand that. You know, for someone to sit there and, you know, say it's wrong, this, that, and the third, and then turn around and, you know, come forward about her whole ex-boyfriend or boyfriend thing is kind of odd to me.
Well, this to me is indicative of what we tend to see out here, right? The the outrage, the finger pointing, and then, you know, if you saw let me see if I still can find her tweet, right? Her tweet, she ends it by saying, "The left is so stupid." And you're like, this had nothing to do with Democrats.
True. Yeah.
This had nothing to do with the Democrats. So why not just own it? Why not the fact that you've been out here sowing seeds of discord amongst the American people, but then in your own backyard, you're benefiting off the very thing you're telling us not to do.
Oh, I totally agree with you, but, you know, Like I said, you know, there's probably a lot of things that we don't agree on, but I'm always in your lives, you know, listening and whatnot. So,
yeah. So is there something that, you know, because I talk to real Republicans like yourself, mm-hmm. what can the Democrats do to help you rid your party of the hypocrisy? Do you feel like you're outnumbered?
Get this Trump mentality out of everything. Trump is not God, people. Come on, man.
Oh. Well. I'm going to give you a round of applause. And a follow. So.
Thank you, sir.
We are all on the same page about getting Donald J. Trump out.
Absolutely.
Out of politics. Mm. Now,
if he broke the law, lock him up, the way I look at it. If Joe Biden breaks the law, if Hunter Biden breaks the law, Hillary breaks the law, Obama, my neighbor down the street named Jim Joe broke the law, lock him up.
Lock them up. So let me ask you this. What percentage of the Republican Party would you say feels the way that you feel?
There's not a lot, I can tell you that, because of this whole MAGA bull crap.
So
one man can't make the country completely stable, can't make it financially set, can't do any of that. It takes more than one person to do that. And to my name, we the people of the country can make it better, not just one particular person.
I agree. So my next question, because this is one that I think confuses me, why do you feel, and if you don't feel comfortable answering it, that's fine, but it's something that I'm just, you know, I'm working on in terms of how to approach it, right? What do you say about the Republican Party? Like, for instance, you, what will it take for you to just say, you know what, I'm done being a Republican? How low does this need to go before you say, I'm done with it?
I don't really know what to say on that, honestly.
Well, I mean, because the ship is sinking. As far as I'm concerned, you said you're outnumbered right now on a ship that's metaphorically sinking. At some point, you're going to go down with it, or you got to jump ship.
True. I agree with you there. But I think, you know, there's some aspects on the Republican side, there's some aspects on the Democrat side that's both good, but a lot of them are not. Some people are going to disagree with the Republicans, some people are going to disagree with the Democrats, but it all comes down to just political gain, the way I look at it. It don't matter who you are, what color you are, what gender you are, any of that crap. As long as you stick to what you say and stick to what you can do for the country to make it better, do it. Don't beat around the bush. Get to work and get it done.
I mean, I agree. I agree. Like I said, me and you agree so much. It's like, why not just join the Democrats?
I've been a Republican since I was old enough to even vote. I mean, it was just the whole mentality, how it come down from my grandfather, my dad, and, you know,
cut it out, Mr. Nice Guy. I am working. You see me in the flesh. You get to work. You see me on the field. Cut it out. Now, you said you've been a Republican all your life, and I'm fine. I'm fine with that. Trust me, I really am. But it's almost like you're in an abusive relationship, right? At a certain point, it's time to say, this needs to stop or it's only going to get worse.
Oh, you ain't wrong there.
I mean, listen, I appreciate your honesty, so let's get straight to it. How low does the Republican Party need to go before you say, I'm done with it?
If they lay out all the corruption and all that crap, and then, you know, I think more people will open their eyes up and realize that the Republican Party or the Democrat Party, or whichever party you believe in, I think once there's more material laid out, I think people will start to realize and wake up.
So do you believe that, and I thank you for, you know, at least sharing this perspective with me, because a lot of people that I know are, you know, loyal Republicans, they say the same thing as you, and my question is still the same, right? Do you believe that once he's indicted, do you believe that once he's indicted, perhaps by Jack Smith or these other prosecutors, do you think that will help the Republican Party?
Absolutely. Because it's not going to just start with Donald Trump. It's going to go down the line, because Donald Trump is a businessman. You know, he likes money. They're going to offer him some kind of deal to throw everybody else under the bus, and he is not going to stand for anybody. Look at the whole the Proud Boys, all that crap that happened at January 6th at the Capitol. I mean, he's going to throw everybody he can under the bus to save his own hind parts.
So what you're saying is you're holding out for the Republican Party because somewhere down the line, you support Jack Smith indicting the former president and possibly cleaning house in the entire Republican Party, and this is what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. And one last thing.
Yep.
What exactly about the Democrat Party don't you align with?
Well, see, I don't know too, like I said, I don't know too much about the Democratic Party. I know who the president, vice president, you know, all that stuff. But I don't really look in too far into the Democratic side because, like I said, I've been a Republican all my life. And I don't know too much about it because I really don't want to speak on something I don't know.
So you're leaving the door open to possibly being a Democrat somewhere down the road, right?
If the shoe fits, wear it.
Okay, okay, okay. Well, listen, I'm going to hold out. I'm going to keep holding out for you, bro, because I don't see where you and I differ too much other than just in terms of you saying you're a Republican. But, you know, we're more than happy to have you jump on board and leave that ship that is currently sinking due to all of the lies and misinformation and corruption that's weighing it down.
Well, see, I haven't voted in the last three elections, if that'll tell you anything.
So you didn't vote for Obama?
No.
You didn't vote for Trump?
No.
Well, that's interesting. Who did you vote for last? George Bush?
Yes.
You didn't vote for Obama the first time?
No, I did not.
I don't know. I mean, this is very, very interesting. But I think you're a man. It sounds like you're a man of integrity, and you have your reasons. So, and I respect them. I respect them. But I'm going to say this: if we're going into this next election cycle, and it comes down to Joe Biden or President Trump, who will you vote for?
Depends on how these proceed.
Huh? Hi, Shane. Uh-oh,
depends on
you.
If he gets...
I think I'm losing you. Well, listen, I guess, are you on the road or something? Because it sounds like you're fading away, we the people. So, I appreciate you checking in, but I'm going to go to the next guest. Fair enough? All right. I don't know if he can hear me, but listen, brother, you're always welcome to come into the box. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, we the people. He's a real honest Republican. I appreciate it. It seems like we're getting some real Republicans that are starting to feel comfortable coming into the live and sharing their opinions about what's going on. As I've said before, you're always welcome as well to come in and testify and tell the truth. And I do appreciate it. I do appreciate it that he was willing to hold the former president and his cronies accountable for their dirty, disgusting, filthy deeds. Bringing up our next guest. Oh, all right. Cut it out, Justice. Greetings. I don't know if it's going to connect. Trump for treason. I don't think it's connecting. Uh-oh. Well, I guess We have heard from all of our guests today. Tommy, I don't know if you want to send another guest request, but we have heard from all of our guests today, ladies and gentlemen. And so with that being said, I would consider today to be a great day. I think the truth has been found today in Olympus. And there are no more forms of lies and misinformation to tolerate or deal with. So, yes, I agree with you, brother attacking. It is a great day. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, you are all released from class. Order! Now, before I get up out of here, you know what we got to do. You got to play everybody's favorite song. We'll always vote for Republican. Why would you always vote for Republican after you've just heard me set a bunch of people free today? I don't know. I don't got time. I'm on my way out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, take care. We are out of here.
Who's always the most handsome in the kingdom?
And I really am, ladies and gentlemen. Have a great day. You did it.
Zeus. This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like Zeus.
I can't leave it up to you.
I can't hang around with you. You fall in love.
Thank you.
You a high
Brandon.
Risk.
It's all yes. In the mix. Thank you for that gift.
This is way above the
head. Thank
you. Kyle
Bailey.
Rudy. Time to let loose with the truth.
Angela. Thank you.
Patty. I know the ladies love me because I'm sweet like a tooth.
Yes.
I ain't hating on the gods, but he's such a
truth.
But you had to light my fuse.
I'm catching all these snakes
like a mongoose.
Fighting!
Yeah, I'm the
yes,
one that they choose.
H.
You know I'm so handsome.
CSC that's why they call me.
This is how I move when I'm
Christina.
Walking like Zeus.
Yes.
This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like
yes.
To act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus.
Don't be
playing with my mood when I'm moving like Zeus. You're thinking that you caught
cut it out
like
with the
like
drop
Zeus. Thunder in the sky like you
not
look like
the cat,
Zeus.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm my own rules. I'm a god, call me Zeus. I'm in Hollywood, and I'm living for the
moment.
You say you want it fast, well, I'm living proof. I've been waiting for this moment. Now I gotta choose. If you play around with love, then you're guaranteed to lose.
Brother
I didn't
Anthony.
Make the game of rules, so don't play me like a fool. If you can't swim, don't be in the pool.
Larry,
even though I'm
you.
People telling
Myron.
Me to cool. I'm just sitting on my throne while you looking like a goof.
Time
to let it loose with the truth. Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose. I know the ladies love me cause I'm sweet like a tooth. Play a hating on the gods, boy, you such a douche.
Try to
keep you happy like a fuse. Catching all these snakes like a mongoose.
Yes, it is
ladies
coming.
Love
yes.
Me, yeah, I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome, that's why they call me Zeus.
Oh,
this is
how I yeah,
when
thank
I'm
you.
Like Zeus. This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like Zeus. You thinking that you're cool till I pull up like Zeus. Thunder
yes.
In the sky like you up like Zeus. I make my own rules, I'm a god, call me Zeus.
Yeah, you know about me.
You know about me, ladies and
like
gentlemen.
Wild Zeus.
You know I do.
I'm the goddess of God, you know what I'm saying?
I really am.
I'm breaking down the roof with this heat.
Mountain Negro.
Now I'm on the beat, kicking hard like Bruce.
Born green on the beat.
Better call the truth, ladies and gentlemen.
I can dance and box in the jungle like a kangaroo. Don't get caught slipping in the woods or you'll be dead like a
Lindsay on the beat like Zeus.
Lindsay.
Angelo on the beat like Zeus. RLC on the beat. Yeah, you heard about Green.
Thank you.
Bertha.
Myron, thank you.
Yeah, ladies.
Poker Dad,
it's
thank you.
It's Zeus.
Smile daily. You really should smile more. That cracks me up. Yes, let's go, Bonnie Willis. Smile daily. You do need to smile more, okay? Because you're sounding like you're frowning over there, champion. And I know this truth is so hard to digest, but you just need to keep listening and you'll come around. Lakers, Laker fans, I'm not going to say anything, but that you know what? We're willing to talk after this game, this next game. So I won't judge. I won't judge. All right. Have a great rest of your Monday morning. Take care, folks.